Okay, so today we're going to do Disco 2000 by Pulp. Now, I've been kind of taken aback by the reaction I've gotten from Pulp viewers, I guess people who watch my reactions to Pulp. Apparently, a lot of people like them, so that's very nice to know. And yeah, so today we're going to do Disco 2000. Apparently, this is a, one of their best songs, so I'm ready. Let's get into it and see what's going on. Okay, I liked that a lot. So yeah, Pulp and Disco 2000. I guess I can see where the 2000 comes in there with let's all meet up in the year 2000. I have to say again, I mean, with every Pulp reaction I do, I have to talk about Jarvis's voice, Jarvis Cocker, the lead singer. Again, I love what he when he does his whispers, how he whispered Deborah's name, and he actually whispered it a couple times. And I was actually thinking, I guess throughout the whole song, I was just thinking about the story of the song, if this was real or not, I guess. Because I know he's done, other songs I've heard. They were, I guess, true tales, basically, things that actually happened to him. And so, yeah, I would think that this is probably something else that happened, I guess. And then, yeah, I just really liked his vocal performance, I guess, is what I could say. I mean, with his oohs and going on, his whispers, and I don't know, I just really like his voice. Just a nice voice to listen to. And yeah, and of course, I would say my nose is itchy as well, but I would say here, the personnel, it shows that there is two guitarists, Russell Senior and Mark Weber. It doesn't show which one, I guess, they just say both on guitar. But it sounded like an electric guitar, I guess, there, especially at the start. Yeah, I just liked that a lot. I liked that inclusion in the song and how the song started off. It sounded kind of grimy. It sounded, yeah, I just didn't know what was going to happen. And then all of a sudden, the drums came in, and I really liked it. It sounded like, I guess the word would be like, it sounded like galloping, I guess, is the sound I heard, just a galloping beat. And I really like that. And yeah, I mean, the whole song came together, and of course Jarvis comes in and does his thing, and I liked it a lot. So I will talk about the song here, the About, on genius.com, right off the bat. So this is one of the band's most famous songs. So yes, like I said, it's off their seminal 1995 album, and Disco 2000 is a Britpop classic, which sees Jarvis Cocker talk about his childhood sweetheart and imagines where and who she is now. So basically, yeah, it's a true story, I guess. And I really like how Jarvis could do this, talk about especially a childhood sweetheart, Deborah. And it's like, I don't think I ever had, no, I don't think I had a childhood sweetheart, but obviously Jarvis kind of did. And it's a fun little, possibility. It's a fun thought. It's like, oh, where are they at now? But just going through the lyrics here, there are some annotations. So it says with the first verse, oh, here, or we were born within 1 hour of each other. So obviously they're quite close in age. Our mother said we could be sister and brother. Your name is Deborah, Deborah. It never suited you. So it says from Jarvis's book, Mother, Brother, Lover. He says, I was born in Nether Edge Hospital, Sheffield, on September 19th, 1963. The woman in the bed next to my mother gave birth to a daughter a few hours later. The girl was christened Deborah Farnell, or Farnell, I guess, and we were in the same class all the way through school. So, of course, they kind of built a relationship since birth, I guess you would say. And then it goes on, and they said that when we grew up, we'd get married and never split up. Oh, we never did it, although I often thought of it. So obviously, he really put a lot of thought into all of this, but Deborah probably, maybe she might have thought of it, but obviously, Jarvis is the one that made a song out of all of it. But it says for annotation here, we are shown something that resembles remorse in his unfulfilled fate. They had been told that they would get around to it. In the position he is in, he would most likely appreciate something like that as he gets older. The year 2000 is approaching, and he's still maturing in that sense. I don't know what this means. It's not really written well. But basically, what I'm getting, yeah, it's just like, they'd say that we'd grow up and marry each other, just basically, because they knew each other since they were born, but it never happened. And then, in the year 2000, it's like the year 2000's come along. This was 1995. So yeah, I just really like how they talk about in the year 2000. And of course, the year 2000, I was two, but the whole thing that was going to happen in 2000 with Y2K and all that, you never know. So then it goes on to the pre-chorus. So it says, oh, Deborah, do you recall your house is very small with wood chip on the wall? So it says, Deborah didn't live in a glamorous house. Wood chip is a type of wallpaper. It goes on, and nowadays it's considered an eyesore to many. So obviously, yes, she didn't grow up in a great, I guess, house, whatever, but at least she still grew up in a house. with the chorus, "Let's all meet up in the year 2000. Won't it be strange when we're all fully grown? Be there 2 o'clock by the fountain down the road." So there's a annotation there. So it says the fountain down the road is the main fountain complex in Sheffield, England, hometown of Pulp. So obviously this would be the fountain that they're talking about. And then he says, "I never knew that you'd get married." So obviously, it says Deborah married a man called Colin Bone. Great last name, but remained close friends with Cocker throughout her life. Okay, so that's good. Sadly, she died in 2015, not long after Cocker sang this song for her at her 50th birthday. Okay, so I like how they did all of this. I didn't know if he was just, fawning over her and she was just like, "Get away from me," or whatever, what she would think about all of this. But it's nice to know that Cocker sang this for her at her birthday, and that it was all fine, that she got married to somebody else and all that stuff. That's nice. That's a nice ending to this whole story, honestly. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the annotations. And just looking at the outro, "Oh, what are you doing Sunday, baby? Would you like to come and meet me? Maybe you can't even bring your baby." So it says there is another annotation. "It seems notable that Jarvis suggests that Deborah brings her baby after referencing Deborah herself as baby 2 lines earlier. Obviously, when Jarvis calls Deborah baby, he's using the word as an endearment. Nothing about its colloquial use here is out of place. It makes sense to call a woman baby in a rock song, blah blah blah. The second use of the baby, it says here, the baby seems to have two meanings. It could refer to Deborah's child or her husband. So yeah, of course, again, I just like how it all comes back together, where Jarvis is like, "Look, we can still hang out. We're not gonna get married, whatever, all this stuff, but we can be friends, and it can all work out." So yeah, it's a really nice story altogether with this song, and I really have to go back to one lyric though, which I thought was kind of funny. I mean it's everyone goes through middle school, whatever. And with the start of the second verse, it says, "You were the first girl at school to get breasts, and Martin said that you were the best. Oh, the boys all loved you, but I was a mess." so it says, Jarvis Cocker never has the well-polished superstar image, often quoted in interviews to buy his clothes from charity shops, but still looks cool. So again, it's just like, Jarvis never probably thought, he was, a good-looking guy, whatever. He never thought that a girl would go for him, and he didn't feel like going for the girl, I guess, basically. But yeah, I like the whole part, you were the first one in school to get breasts. It's just like, and I guess, hormones for, I guess, boys when they're at that age, it's just like you notice that stuff. And then, of course, but then I like how it says, he would walk her home, and it meant nothing to her, but it meant a lot to him because she was popular. So I just like how, it's just, again, I like this whole story. It's a nice song, and I can see why it's so big. Again, I just always love, I guess, just the instrumentation of Pulp, especially on this album. And I like the album cover as well. I don't know what's going on there. I guess it looks like some kind of wedding. I guess somebody could comment down below what that means. But yeah, it's just an interesting song and a nice story. And it sucks that she died in 2015, but at least he got to sing this song to her. That's a really nice story. And yeah, that's about it. And I want to also say again, what I said at the start, an electric guitar I thought was in. I think it's electric guitar. I could be wrong. Maybe I am. People might have already commented down below, but I thought it sounded like an electric guitar. It doesn't specify on the personnel here. So, yeah, anyway, I just wanted to say that. So, thanks for watching, I guess. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. Really appreciate all the support, especially on these Pulp reactions. And yeah, I really love Britpop, and I found Pulp here, and it's just been a nice little ride. So, anyway, I'll talk to you guys again soon.